Welcome back to the show, everyone. Our next guest sings beautiful songs.
She certainly does. She's going to perform the title track off of the album Beautiful Things. And if you want to see Lee Aaron in concert, you can see her in Calgary at the Deerfoot Casino on July 19th. Here is Lee Aaron.
Feast my eyes, show me unsearchable things, river deep and river wide, waters on the rise. Come by you. Here I stand, here I see, show me such beautiful things, heart of you and heart of me, open from inside. By you, my love, come by you, come by you, my love, come by you, come by you.
Welcome back to Urban Rush. Our next guest is a very successful mother, artist, and business person as well.
That's right, and that's why she's speaking at the Enterprising Moms Business Summit. She's here now. You just heard her perform. Lee Aaron, how are you?
It's good. Hi, I'm great.
Yeah.
It's great to be here.
We haven't seen you in a little bit.
I love the Argyle sweater.
Me too.
Well, thank you so much. We haven't seen you in a bit. You've been having family.
I've been having babies, yes. Yeah. My husband and I have two amazingly beautiful children.
What age are they now?
My daughter, Angela, is turning 4, actually this Saturday. That was one of my slates that I did. And
happy
my
birthday.
Son, Our son Jet is 2.5 and loves trains.
Two and a half year old boy, Lee. How much of a 4 year old girls? They can be pretty, you know, angelic at that stage. Thus the name, I would imagine.
Yep.
But 2.5 year old boy, how's that going?
he's off and running. You know, I was explaining earlier, like, we got a trampoline. I think he actually learned to walk on the trampoline. It was kind of a safety zone. He could just run around on the mat, bounce off the netting, and it was great, you know.
So he's
wild.
Boys
he's wild.
Are so it's, different from girls when they're little like that, huh?
Yeah, he's amazing, though.
Did you take some time away from music, or were you always working on it as you're sort of
dribs
raising
and
the
drabs,
kids?
And, you know, I had, my husband and I had 2 children in a very short period of time. We had our daughter, and then 19 months later, we had our son.
You qualify for Irish twins.
You do.
That's
I do.
Very nice.
No.
Yeah, I think
Thank
so.
You.
That's pretty close.
And so it was, you know, it's pretty intense, as you know, if you're a parent, yeah. right? So, yes, a minor hiatus. And this year, especially, I've been getting back into things a bit.
Nice.
And so it's been an interesting adventure, balancing motherhood and trying to have a career. But
how do you manage that as a singer-songwriter? Because, you know, when you're writing, you have to strike when it hits you artistically, and then you've got 2 little munchkins running around, and you're running your own business in your home. How do you balance everything?
Handheld tape recorder.
Nice,
running
really?
Running to the bathroom. La, 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 la. Okay.
Do
okay,
you really?
Back.
That's great.
Laptop in the dining room. They're watching Treehouse and having lunch.
Quickly.
Some emails.
Oh, that's really
it's
funny.
Crazy. Actually, my husband is like the king of multitasking. Like, he does things for short periods of time, and he kind of taught me this technique of, because I used to have to have hours of intense time,
yeah.
and I've just gotten better at being able to fit things in little increments, and it works out pretty good. And creative time, mostly, you know, when everyone's
late night.
Quiet, yeah, everyone's asleep, and And it's funny, I just had a conversation with my pianist that we went out for a coffee,
yeah.
and I was telling him, you know, that creativity, I think the best songs always write themselves in 10 minutes. They just fall into place. Like, you're just the vessel. It just goes, whoosh, and it happens, right? And so it's sort of, I've been put in a position now where I can only write the best songs because
right.
I don't have time.
You only got 10 minutes.
I don't have time to be self-indulgent.
And,
you know?
And do you ever know what you're going to get? I mean, people have seen a progression in your music throughout your career. And this album, I think, is even maybe a little bit of a departure from jazz
yeah.
when you were doing that. It's sort of a bit of a progression. Do you know when you go in, or do you know when you start writing what you're gonna end up with at the end?
No, not really. No, the truth, no, really. You know what? I think essentially I am a pop songwriter. I love jazz music, and I did a fairly major foray into jazz in the late 90s and
yeah.
into the new millennium. And the sort of next stepping stone from the jazz album that I put out in 2000 was Beautiful Things. It's got a lot of jazz and blues influences, but
yeah.
most of the songs are original. And the next album as well, I think, is going to maybe go a little more in an adult contemporary pop direction with jazzy instrumentation.
Yeah.
Just
well, and you
that.
Must find yourself yeah. in an interesting position when you play a show, because you have this body of work you can draw from rock and roll all the way up to, you know, the jazz and the pop songs as well. So do you try and satisfy everybody
well,
when you play a song?
Just recently I've started doing a new show. An interesting story, I was playing an all-women's sort of arts festival a couple of years ago when I was, we were pregnant with my son.
Yeah.
And the promoter of the big rock festival in, I think it was Thunder Bay, Ontario, said, I'd love to book you for the rock festival next summer, but you gotta include some of your rock
yeah.
hits. And I thought, okay, how can I do this, right? And I, you know what, I was going to be able to play with Heart, and so I really wanted to do the show.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
No kidding.
Yeah, it was awesome. And you know what, Nancy Wilson and I had this great talk before we went on. Mostly we talked about our families and our kids.
Yeah.
It was fun.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I found some great players. I have an amazing band, and I put together a show that, it's sort of a revamp of some of my old songs.
Yeah.
You know, they're not maybe quite as heavy-handed, which incorporates, and it incorporates quite a bit of things, stuff from Beautiful Things. And
do you still play Metal Queen?
And some jazz. Well,
a little bit?
Version.
Yeah.
A bit.
It must be nice to go back and reclaim that in a way that you want to as well.
Absolutely.
And not be dictated
absolutely.
By other things.
And you know, it's a real sort of, it's a more mature show. It's very, family friendly,
yeah.
if that makes sense, And what I the feedback that I've gotten so far, people have said, you know, it's really nice for it to not just be wall of sound, to have like, okay, there's that fun
to
rock song, and then there's a real breath, breathing space in the set. You know what I mean? So
it's
been very fun.
Very cool. Thank you so much, Lee. And if you want to hear more of Lee, as we mentioned off the top, she's going to be speaking at the Enterprising Moms Business Summit. That's right. She does it all with two kids around, and you can too. That's at the Four Seasons Hotel, June 8th from noon till 6 o'clock. You can find out more information on their website.
Yeah,
Thanks so much.
Writing songs, but running your own label as you do stuff. Ah, super easy. Anytime. Lee, thank you. That was
thank
really
nice to see you.
It was a real pleasure to be here.
Thanks.